Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Thank you so much for coming to another session of 99 Names of Allah. Alhamdulillah, this is our 25th session. So we'll be crossing the 80 name mark today, inshallah. And so it's been quite the trip, but still got a little bit more ground to cover, inshallah, as we have after this five more sessions and just under 20 names then left, inshallah. So last time we talked about the names of Al-Zahir, Al-Batin, Al-Wali, and Al-Muta'ali. Al-Zahir we defined and mentioned to be the manifest, the revealed, the visible. And Al-Batin was the hidden, the invisible, the secret one. Al-Wali was the protecting ruler, the protecting governor, the protecting patron. And Al-Muta'ali was the sublime, the highest, the uppermost, the self-exalted. And what we got from these names was how Allah is manifest in so many different ways within the world, but also just how intimate Allah is regardless of these different manifestations, whether Allah is manifest, whether Allah is hidden, whether Allah is in a patron type relationship, or if Allah is just the Most High, that does not create a distance between the worshiper, between the servant of Allah and the servants of Allah and Allah, that distance does not get affected, that spiritual distance, that relationship does not get affected based on the different manifestations and ways that Allah is in the world. So inshallah, we use these names as a way to not just see ourselves as more distant from Allah, but see how Allah is close to us despite the different manifestations, different ways. And the last thing being that everything in this world helps give us a reminder, or in some way, shape, or form is a manifestation of these divine sparks we've been talking about. So Allah is manifest in so many of these different ways. In a sense, the reflections are there. So these signs, these things around us, the things within ourselves, when we're more mindful, when we're more vigilant, we see these in our lives, and we see these as reflections of Allah and reminders. So we take that as such. Today we will be covering the names Al-Barr, At-Tawwab, and Al-Muntaqim, and Al-Afu. So Al-Barr is the one who relieves the burden, the one who is loving, who does good, and Al-Tawwab is the one who accepts repentance. Al-Muntaqim is the one who repays justly, the avenger, and Al-Afu is the one who forgives, the pardoner. So inshallah, we'll go ahead and we'll begin with those shortly right after we do the Asma al-Husna. So I will share my screen, inshallah, and then we will begin that. Bismillah. All right. So let us begin, inshallah. As always, you just take these names in as you are comfortable and as makes you centered with the divine presence. And so we mentioned yesterday the name of Al-Zahir and the manifest. So, and also Al-Batin. So look at these names and see where the divine is manifest or is reflected, or these divine sparks are manifested or reflected in your life, in the world around you, and in these attributes, inshallah. So let us begin. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الرحمن الرحيم المالك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر الخالق البارئ المصور الغفار القحار الوهاب الرازق الفتاح العليم القابض الباسط الخافض الرافع المعز المذل السميع البصير الحكم العدل اللطيف الخبير الحليم العظيم الغفور الشكور العلي الكبير الحفيظ المقيت الحسيب الجليل الكريم الرقيب المجيب الواسع الحكيم الودود المجيد الباعث الشهيد الحق الوكيل القوي المتين الولي الحميد المحسي مبدي المعيد المهيي المميت الحي القيوم الواجد الماجد الواحد الأحد الصمد القادر المقتدر المقدم المؤخر الأول الآخر الظاهر الباطن الوالي المتعالي البر التواب المنتقيم العفو الرؤوف مالك الملك ذو الجلال والإكرام المقسط الجامع الغني المغني المانع الضار النافع النور الهادي البديع الباقي الوارث الرشيد الصبور. So with these names, inshallah, we begin with our names today, the assigned divine names. And I believe, I can't remember if I had mentioned, I might have left this one out, but today we'll be covering Al-Barr, Al-Tawwab, Al-Muntaqim, and Al-Afu. And so let us go ahead and begin with these names, inshallah. So Al-Barr. Al-Barr is the name that refers to the one who relieves the burden, the loving, the one who does good, the kind, the source of goodness. So the source of goodness. And Al-Barr is the one who kindly and generously grants wealth, the one who generously grants health, material blessings, all the things in life that we associate as things that are blessings that we can see. But also the things on the spiritual level, granting faith, returning good deeds, fostering piety in hearts. Remember, Al-Barr being the source of goodness, but also goodness in action. And the root of Al-Barr contains meanings of being reverent, being dutiful and devoted, being charitable, being beneficent, doing good, giving out of one's own charity, but or giving out one's own wealth, one's own portions, to honor, to be honest, and also piety, righteousness, kindness. So many positive and warm things that come from this name. And when we do good to people, when we do good to the creation around us, when we do good to all that is around us, but also when we do good to ourselves, like doing honestly good to ourselves, we feel that reflection of Al-Barr. We feel that essence, that spark that is there, but also we see that on our scale, what that feels like. What does it feel like when you do something good to other people? What does it feel like when you do something good to yourself? And what that makes you feel like, and now multiply it by an infinite amount to see how this is an attribute of Allah in terms of doing good to the creation, doing good to that which worships Allah. And so we lifted this concept up in an earlier name, but perfection is a quality that is in Allah alone. You know, as much as we like to strive for perfection, we know human beings, and it's a part of our nature that we're not perfect, that we'll make mistakes. And, you know, by design, we will make mistakes, but so that we might seek forgiveness. And there was a quote, I believe it was from Shams Tabrizi. If I'm mistaken, I'll get a correction here. But who said that there is, you know, Allah has all these qualities, all these different qualities, except one. And it's brokenness. It's that concept of imperfection. And so as humans, we should lift up that brokenness, lift up that imperfection as something we bring to Allah, something that we bring to Allah because Allah will treat to us with kindness. Allah will repay us in a way that helps fill that area, helps fill that brokenness, helps anneal those cracks and those fractures, because that is what Allah is, and that's something that we are missing. So it gives us that draw of that compliment. And al-barr is conducive to this because it's the kindness that is, it's manifested in the kindness that is offered to those even who oppose Allah, those who at times in their life will oppose Allah, who do evil, they will be forgiven, who also then ask for forgiveness, but then also granting forgiveness and accepting apologies. So we see al-barr in action, and this goodness in action, not just a one-time deal that if you wrong Allah, then it's all said and done, because there is that concept of forgiveness. There's that concept of apology and repentance, which we'll get to with at-tawwab. But it covers our mistakes, it covers our weaknesses, and the blessings come in so many different forms. And we see this in the lifetime of the Prophet ﷺ, that for some of the Muslim converts, some of those blessings, depending on where they were coming from, some of those were material. Some of those were material in that blessing, and their hearts didn't turn to Allah until they were given a material recompense, or that they saw how Islam like brought to them that same type of prosperity that they enjoyed in Jahiliyyah. But then also for other people, it just changed their heart. It changed their heart because it accepted them as they were, despite of how far gone they had become. And it elevated them to seemingly unattainable ranks in terms of their status in this world, spiritual status. And so as we wrap up with this name, we recognize how it fills our heart with joy. It fills the heart with joy, but it also heals the heart. It's an active healer, but it makes you feel good. And it grants you a sense of dignity, a sense of satisfaction, knowing that you may make mistakes. Inevitably, as human beings, you'd make mistakes. Prophet ﷺ said that, Allah created this nation, and if you, referring to humanity and to the Muslims, if you didn't sin, then Allah would bring forth a nation that would sin just so that they could ask for forgiveness. And so we see how important this concept is, of not just in the sense of we make mistakes, but when we do make mistakes, we're conscious that we repent for those mistakes, that we have a creator, we have a God for whom mistake making is not the end of the line, that it's not the end all be all. It is actually the fountainhead of gaining access to Allah. Is when we recognize our shortcomings, we turn for repentance and forgiveness, and that we have a God with the quality of al-barr that will accept, but also be kind, be gentle, and be loving in relieving that burden that we carry, all these burdens that we have. So this name helps us really find that inner and outer balance. It helps us take an honest look at the way we see ourselves time and time again, and it helps us reflect and see how can we grow, how can we not only relieve our burdens, but what can we do in a sense to do it ourselves, because we don't feel like we can, we just want to dump it all on Allah, but it gives us a sense of agency. And so ultimately this name helps us transform in a genuine, honest, sincere, and respectful way. And we know that in order to get to this name, the qualities that we lifted up are rooted in truthfulness, sincerity, presence, and being genuine. And that this name helps not only us in a sense transform ourselves, this name not only in a sense helps us access that divine kindness, that divine lovingness, but also the source of goodness. This name helps us, as with all the other names, have the external effect and the internal effect. And the external effect being that we not only seek to become good to people around us, but we seek to become good within us, because al-barr is the source of goodness. And so we know within Allah, within the divine presence, that there is this call to be good. There's this call to be good, but then there's also the one on the same side that will relieve any burdens that we that we take on, any thorns in the road that might manifest. And so what we take away from this name is we, as Allah is al-Barr, as Allah is the source of goodness, the one who relieves burdens, so too should we be that way to the people in our lives, to the creation in our lives. It doesn't have to be human. It can be the environment. It can be other things that don't have a voice, that don't have eyes, that can't speak for themselves. And doing good to the world around you, but then also relieving the burden of the world around you, relieving the burden of others. And in doing so, we also be mindful to do, as with everything that we've said here, we do it to ourselves as well. So we do good to ourselves. Our bodies have a right over us. And the Prophet ﷺ said that the bodies have a right over you, and that right is rest. So being able to rest, in, I know Ramadan is kind of a marathon type of month, but we owe ourselves that rest. And in the sense of, you know, the owing ourselves that burden relief, we take on so many burdens, but being mindful to relieve ourselves of those when the time is appropriate. So inshallah, with that name, we now transition into At-Tawwab. At-Tawwab is the one who connects to this name because it's the one who accepts repentance, but then the one who leads to return. The root of this name has meanings of to repent, to be penitent, to turn from sin, to renounce, but to forgive, to be merciful. And it's a name of return. At-Tawwab is the one who beckons for our return, who repeatedly turns humanity towards repentance, but also is the one waiting there with open arms when we do make mistake and when we do offer our repentance. And it's the one who forgives those who return to goodness, those who are maybe feeling downtrodden, feeling just, you know, at the end of the scale, the ones who decide to turn. Allah restores those to grace, restores those to grace who repents. And it's the one who forgives those as well who forgive others. And as I mentioned, that this name has this connotation here in a sense that the one who accepts repentance, the one who leads to return. So there's a facilitation in this return, but there's also this accepting of repentance. And our role kind of comes right in the middle of there, that we take the initiative to make that repentance. We take the initiative, we're cognizant there, we have that agency to make that repentance. And so Allah gives us various situations, chances, and opportunities in life that we will, you know, have kind of like a back and forth on. And but these are designed so that we may return to Allah's divine love and reconnect with Allah. They might be difficult situations. They might be the most difficult situations. They may be the easiest ones. But the ultimate result of these, or the ultimate purpose of these, is that they come back to Allah, regardless of what they look like. And so we see in this name that from Allah, who is capable of forgiveness, of all forgiving, of accepting repentance, that when we internalize this name, when we are capable of forgiveness, we can forgive those who have upset or hurt us. And when we forgive ourselves as well, when we acknowledge we've done wrong, but that's not the end of our story, we can feel the divine spark of this name in us and in the world around us. And we know from the Prophet ﷺ, the emphasis on how repentance, how this tawbah is a source of purification. And it's a means to start again on the way home after getting lost. When we look at the pious predecessors, when we look at those whom we revere in the faith, in our earlier tradition, and we see their lives, and we see how their lives turned around, but even also during Islam, when they did make mistakes, when they did, you know, maybe do some things that they were sincerely, you know, repenting for. But, you know, what if their lives are not defined just by that mistake? Their lives are not just defined by that slip or that incident in which they did they messed up. You know, it wasn't defined there, but their life takes on such a greater meaning when they went into repentance, when they went to seek forgiveness. And so for us, it tells us that the story doesn't end with our mistakes. We'll make mistakes, we will wrong people, we'll do so many things here, but what the ultimate thing is, that that's not the end point there, that you can get past this, you can get above this by choosing to repent. Because when you choose to repent and when you exercise that agency and Allah helps facilitate that, Allah is the one waiting there with open arms, in the sense that accepting that repentance, accepting this love that is there, and giving giving that forgiveness. So we be mindful of this, that as Allah forgives, as Allah is good and the source of forgiveness, and as Allah accepts repentance, so too in our time, in our lives, in our small spheres here, we also be people who accept the repentance of others, but also be willing to accept our own repentance, be able to forgive ourselves, be able to do good to ourselves and to do good to others. And so we transition now to the third name that we're talking about for today, Al-Muntaqim. Al-Muntaqim has the name, the Avenger, the one who repays justly, and not the one like in the Disney Marvel Cinematic Universe, but the Avenger has a very different connotation in this sense, and especially in this name, a very spiritual connotation. So the root of this name has so many different meanings, but coming from reward through punishment, taking revenge, rejecting, detesting, being upset, to hold something against someone, but to avenge, to repay, to balance. And Al-Muntaqim is the great avenging campaign, written in the book here, Divine Names by Rosina Fawzi Al-Rawi, that Al-Muntaqim is the great avenging campaign against our own selfishness, against that numbing force that leads us to only see ourselves, covers our hearts, disconnects us from the other. It is the fight against laziness, it's the fight against narrow-mindedness, racism, arrogance, prejudice, and lack of awareness. So you see, so a lot of times when we read this name, if we just see it on the wall, we'll see Allah, Al-Muntaqim, I'll say the Avenger, the one who takes revenge, and you naturally will shake. It's a frightening type of attribute to think about. It's kind of scary. But then you also see the internal aspect of that. You see the deeper meaning of a name like that. And I really appreciated how she had put this together, in the sense that we've been talking about how the names have been a source of healing, how the names have been a source of growth, how a source of just transformation. And lifting up a name like this in this sense, the Avenger, really doing that campaign to us, to help us in purify our heart, because we mentioned that a soft heart, a purified heart, is the one that is open to seeing how Allah is in the world, but seeing also how the divine is manifest in so many different ways, and to open ourselves to that connection to Allah. But because we've gone through life, our heart has become either hardened or has some covers and layers. And so there is really this that's kind of like the hard scrub that you put on. That is literally, the bleach that is put on when some stain cannot get out. Here comes the bleach to really like try and get it out. And Al-Muntaqim is really that intensive campaign that helps us to take out some of those real impurities that we take on, things like racism, things like just a sense of prejudice towards other people, towards a complete ignorance of other people. And so we know that as humans, apart from our creation, our next step of development is essentially connection, connecting to the world around us, connecting to other people, connecting to ourselves. And we're called by this name to be mindful of that connection, to be mindful of how we act. We're called to control our anger. We're called to forgive those who've been unjust to us. We're called to connect and bring together that which has been broken. And we keep Allah in the foreground. We keep Allah in the foreground that we continue to do these things, but we do them mindfully. And so this name helps us come out of our egos. This name helps us increase in connection and bring us that sense of wholeness to continue to work on ourselves. But like I said, so many things cover our hearts. So many things will cloud our hearts and cloud our judgments. We see anything you derive from materialism will do that. Anything that we have, possessions, will do that. And this name helps remove that superficial, the unnatural, the things that we put in priority above Allah, but also above the well-being of ourselves, the well-being of others, the well-being of creation. We put a value to a lot of these things. And so this name really helps remove that, help boost the true inner self, remove the ego, and soften that hardened heart, because the heart, the state of how the heart is, as the Prophet ﷺ taught, it influences the entire body. And we transform that sense of revenge, those sense of anger, that sense of, you know, different things that we may have towards people into compassion. But we think about the inward aspect of this name, how this name really hones in on the things that we've experienced in life, the things that are holding us down, and really polishes those things. And so when we see this name, there shouldn't be a immediate sense that Allah is out to like avenge me, or like take revenge on me, or anything like that. We see how we've gone through this world, and how maybe like just off the path we've gone in a sense. And Allah is not there to just smite us or anything like that for no purpose. Allah is there advocating for us, is rooting for us, wants us to do good, wants to accept our repentance. But sometimes it's just hard for us to get to that stage to even make repentance. And so Al-Muntaqim really goes in and really helps us brush off all of that has been manifested on there, so that we then become more susceptible to being open-minded, being aware, being the opposite of these things of narrow-mindedness, racism, arrogance, prejudice, ignorance, all these things, that we go to the opposite, and then we're able to ask for repentance. We're able to do good. We're able to do the things that Allah has put forth. But this is a name that really is kind of like that bleach on a really bad stain that we've got. But it's there. It has its benefits, and it's there in transforming us ultimately. The last name we have is a beautiful name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the other names as well. But the one who forgives, the one who pardons, in Al-Afu. And Al-Afu, when we read it, when we think about it, we meditate on it, it gives us the strength to overcome humiliation. It gives us that strength to really overcome that sense of just being, you know, so feeling self-reproaching. And it upsets without threat or punishment, solely through kindness and generosity, and without shaming or without feelings of guilt. And so We see that this name does let those mistakes that we make, those minor mistakes here and there, they do get overlooked, in a sense. Not that Allah doesn't keep track. Allah, of course, keeps track of everything. You know, Allah is al-Hasib. Allah has these attributes of being able to count everything and all these things. But in a sense that, as I mentioned earlier, our mistakes don't define us. And so these minor mistakes, when we seek forgiveness, you know, they can be, you can achieve something even greater than before you made that mistake. And so forgiveness is really about covering up those tracks and mistakes, but also not just wiping out, not just forgetting that those mistakes happened, but reconciling them. Reconciling that these are things I did, but I'm not defined by that. I can be so much more than that. And so when we repent for our mistakes, when we really dwell on the mistakes we made, but we think through them and we think about how we could have maybe done better, we see the door of divine mercy open, and we see this forgiveness come in and help us not just forget them, but help us move past them. Because sometimes we do something and we can't ever feel like we live it down. And so we lift this name up to help us move to that next step so that we can get better. The root of this name has the meanings of to eliminate, to restore, to health, to cure, to protect, to save, to recover, to pardon, favor, kindness, all these really beautiful attributes. And Al-Afu is not only the power of forgiveness, but it makes the slightest wounds heal. Not just saying that, hey, you're forgiven, okay, let's clean this, let's put white out on your mistake, and then next, no, it helps, makes even the slightest things we've done turn into sources of healing. And it makes that our heart free again from guilt, free again from these wounds, so that it can bask in that forgiveness. And Al-Tawwab, as I mentioned, the one who accepts repentance, it prepares us for Al-Afu, the one who forgives, the one who is there. It the door is open, and the one who forgives is the active part of that. And so what we take away from this name and all these other names is that the door is open for us. The door is open for us in the areas of repentance, in the areas of forgiveness, but in the area of transformation. And oftentimes, in order to be transformed, in order to get to that next stage of our humanity, to ascend, we need to reconcile where we are, the mistakes we've made, but also know that that doesn't define us. And being cognizant, being forthcoming that we did make mistakes, we did do this, but Allah has better planned for us. And keeping the faith that Allah has better planned for you, regardless of what you've done in the past, even if it was just a few minutes before, that we take things sincerely and repenting sincerely, but we in that repentance, we not only pave the way for ourselves to ascend, but we open ourselves to being better agents for the world around us. And so we make the world a better place. We make our own bodies a better place. We make everything around us a better place. We become better people when we open when we access that open door, when we be okay with owning up to our mistakes and seeking forgiveness. So inshallah, we will conclude with these names and we will conclude with our dhikr. And then tomorrow we'll continue with another set of names here and continue from there. So inshallah, let us go ahead and begin with the dhikr for these names, inshallah. La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, Allah, Allah, Allah. La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, Allah, Allah, Allah. La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, La ilaha illallah, Allah, Allah, Allah. Al-Barr, 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 Al-Barr. Al-Barr, 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 Al-Barr. Ya Barr, 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 Ya Barr. La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, Allah, Allah, Allah. At-Tawwab, 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 At-Tawwab. Ya Tawwab, 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 Ya Tawwab. La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, Allah, Allah, Allah. Al-Muntaqim, 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 Al-Muntaqim. Al-Muntaqim, Al-Muntaqim, Al-Muntaqim. Al-Muntaqim, 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 Al-Muntaqim. Al-Muntaqim, Al-Muntaqim, Al-Muntaqim. Ya Muntaqim, Ya Muntaqim, Ya Muntaqim, Ya Muntaqim. Ya Muntaqim, Ya Muntaqim, Ya Muntaqim. La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, Allah, Allah, Allah. Al-Afu, 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 Al-Afu. Al-Afu, 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 Al-Afu. Ya Afu, 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 Ya Afu. La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, Allah, Allah, Allah. La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, La ilaha illallah, Allah, Allah, Allah. So brothers and sisters, whether you're in the space here, or whether you are watching live or watching this in the future, let us make an intention to keep our hearts open, our eyes open, ourselves open to forgiveness, to others, to and ourselves, that we may access this goodness, that we may access this repentance, and may access a transformation, inshallah. And we'll see you all tomorrow for another set of names of Allah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.